Recently, I did a video on if paid for challenges are better in Bloons TD 6. Are challenges that have a lot of accolades, meaning people gave real life money to those challenges, are they better since they paid for them? Well, we had some mixed results, but I didn't account for the map creator. Map creators are making these crazy, crazy maps, as you can see here with this one called Interstellar, and they're getting a lot of accolades for it, which makes sense because they put tons of hours in. Look at this Kratos one for 30 accolades. Now, I think our top challenge only had about 10 or 11 accolades, so these are completely overpowering them, which makes sense. These are some creative things here. But it was recently brought to my attention by Graham that we have the first map to hit 100 accolades. That means $100 has been given to this map. Is it the best map in the entire game because people have given $100 to it? I don't know, but we're gonna find out here. I'll let you read that name yourself and we're gonna jump into it. But of course we have to do it on hard and chimps because what would a challenge be if it wasn't hard and on chimps? But if you yourself uses accolades or you need to purchase anything from the Ninja Kiwi store, don't forget to head over to settings, click creator support code and type in code DOUBLOON. And I just figured, listen, since this is called juggernaut hole, or however you want to pronounce it, I feel like a juggernaut would just be perfect. Now, does that mean that this map is just like straight up easy? Like it's gonna spin around 4,000 times? No, it doesn't. It goes around once. It goes around once. So we gotta actually think about this then. I think a triple dart start would be pretty awesome, but then that's just so much clutter for later on when I have my main dart right here because I want like the alchemist to get in there. I want the village to get in there. Can we fit everything? We'll have to see. But I think like one good one placed right here, getting all the way up to the spike-a-pult will be pretty good early on, right? It should be just throwing it around because there's a lot of these little jagged steps that these bloons are taking, which I think was intended on purpose. It could have just been like a really fast put together map, but I'm also thinking like the jagged spots are nice because it's gonna make for like a million more ricochets once this thing starts pumping up. Now, we are on chimps, so getting to an apex would be pretty difficult, but if this thing can solo with just a juggernaut and maybe an alchemist, maybe a village, we might see some pretty awesome stuff here and then we get to apex. Or maybe I should have just done impopable to get to there in the first place, but I wanna see how far this thing can go. It looks like the perfect map for it. And that's probably why it has so many accolades. It's like the perfect satisfying map. Like I think a really fun one too would be to something that you could have like a Bloontonium reactor in the middle and it actually spins around enough times that it can take out even a ZOMG. That'd be pretty fun, right? And you just sit there and that takes out everything. There's probably already a map like that. To be honest, I don't spend much time in the map creator stuff just because it's super overwhelming. And then a lot of people copy each other. You'll see like a really cool map, like idea, then like 25 people will do it, which makes sense because that's how it is with a lot of the challenges. So it's like the ones that stick out to me are the really unique one, like Kratos. Like who's gonna try to copy that Kratos one? That's just gonna be too crazy. We already got the juggernaut in the hole. Now I want to get the middle path, of course. So for just camo early on, maybe I should just get like one dart for now just to keep it simple. I just realized too that I don't have a proper hero. So we're probably just gonna rock no heroes on this. I don't see why, it'll just clutter up the screen. I feel like Etienne off to the side would be good, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. So I need to have a village with camo before 33, just in time, so that's awesome. And I really like this, like it's flying around exactly as expected, just all over the place. This is super satisfying. But explain to me in the comments below why this one gets accoladed so much, or if you are an accolade spender, why are you spending it on that particular map? I gotta know. So unfortunately, one juggernaut's not gonna do the trick for that. So we will have to alk buff it. I hope that's enough for it early on, because if it is, then we'll just like carry through this whole thing. There we go. Awesome. Okay, I like it. So we already have our juggernaut. I mean, is this game at this point? I wish I could get rid of these. Maybe I should get a helicopter and like move them out of here so it's just this guy in here. But then I'm thinking like, we might have to get an apex later, right? But will we be able to? Like we're taking out mobs pretty quickly, but I guess we'll have to see like on our first ZOMG. If it makes it like all the way up to here, we're done for. Here's our first BFB and that's actually really quick. So I feel like the ZOMG is gonna be just as crazy. Here's our first ZOMG on 80. We have 20 rounds left until the bad. If it takes it out like right here, things are gonna change. Like look how much damage we're getting here. Okay, that's, but you got also, remember too that the juggernauts are going everywhere. So even though there's four or five ZOMGs, it's not just attacking one at a time, it's hitting them all. So I think we're gonna be able to get to the 90s with just this setup. Can we actually pull off an apex on here on chimps? That'd be really cool. Here's what I was talking about. And exactly as expected, it's working. So, and with it flying around this quick, we might be able to even take out DDTs. If this takes down a bad with just an alchemist and a ultra juggernaut, that is some goofy stuff, but I'm here for it. I'm down for the ride. Our first set of DDTs, if they go out here, we're done. This is, oh yeah. Oh yeah, 95 is gonna be easy. Now we need $150,000. $162,000, why? When did the price get raised? That's not cool. Anyways, we need $162,000, plus we need that. So we need $210,000, and then $235,000 roughly. We need $235,000 to get to the Apex. Now, will throwing a Crossbow Master help at all? Probably absolutely not. So we're kind of on our own. I mean, we will have some three plasmas right here, but it's not like they're doing that great of damage. It's only the Juggernaut that's doing anything. I just let this thing roll and it did pretty well, but we lost on 97, which I mean, somewhat expected. 97 is kind of rough, but I want to see where we went wrong. Is there anything we could do to change with what we have? But honestly, like you're not going to be changing targeting on your Ultra Juggernaut. So it might just be luck at that point. Maybe if we put it on strong only. Yeah, strong might work. That's what you do with eight. No, this time it's going to work. Like, what the heck? Yeah, this game's so weird, man. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. You just got to get lucky. Maybe slowing it down helped that time. I don't know if 98's going to work, though. I wanted just to do like a dart monkey, but the problem is I don't want to spend all of my money because I want to get the Apex, and we're not going to be able to because this guy's 45,000 on his own, you know? So that's a lot. So now we still have to come up with 163. I mean, shattering shells would probably be the best, to be completely honest with you. And it's still not going to work, maybe? Oh, no, that's good. That worked. I mean, I don't see us taking out round 100 with this. But if we can, that's cool. And I don't know why I even... Why didn't I just upgrade that one? I guess it helps to have the extra guy, but there's no chance of this, right? I mean, not terrible. Not completely terrible. So what if we do this, since we know we're going to be doing that later, just doing a bunch of these? But I mean, I feel like a ice would be better at this point. Yeah, ice is probably better. What am I doing? I mean, this might work, but no... So we'll just drop that ability. No, I don't want that to work. I think that'll be an awful way to work. I thought ice would do a lot more. Not his damage particularly, but just the fact that this one's kind of spinning around going crazy. And we're not even close. I mean, I didn't use the ability, so there's that. But let me see. I'll use the ability one time, see if it does anything. And it, I mean, we're getting a few thousand, which is nice. I feel like Gwendolyn would have been a good help because she'd have had that heated up and that would have made this Juggernaut even better. Oh, we're actually breaking it down. Okay. So I restarted and changed it up a bit. So I have a times 10 ultra boosted Juggernaut, and then I have this little alchemist, and then I have Gwyn for the fire it up. And I was thinking this will be cool because at least we can beat the bad with just the Juggernaut as our main attacker. I didn't want a billion towers down, and we still have 50 grand, which is pretty cool. I think we should be able to do this. I mean, we have an ultra boosted Juggernaut. Now, are we going to actually do it? Dude, are you going to take it down to the third one? And why is it spinning around over there? What a weird map. This okay. You got this, buddy. Can you do it? Do it. Come on. Oh my gosh, we did it. We beat it. How far can it go though? Well, it looks like 119 by just buffing him up. Now we could probably do some spike factory, spike storms, you know, that kind of stuff, or maybe a top pass sniper if we had enough for it. But I just want to adjust this guy and he has 8 million damage. I want to do this. Is awesome. We might be able to take on the first one though. The Ultra Jugger, what was it called? Juggernaut map. Juggernaut map. There you go. Is it worth the 100 accolades? Did you guys play this map? Did you like it? Let me know everything that you want me to know in the comments below. And if you have not yet, check out this video. We take on the challenges that cost the most money. The challenges that had the most accolades in Bloons TD6. Are they better than regular challenges? Find out here.